Recently, I've had a few questions about how to do soft proofing in Affinity Photo. So today, I'm going to take a look at how to do it using this photo I shot recently. Now the photo's been adjusted and I've applied all my editing to it, so it's ready now to be sent to the printer. The problem is, I don't know how this will look, and that's where the process of soft proofing comes in. Now to soft proof in Affinity Photo, you need to add a soft proofing layer. And you'll find that under the adjustments. And here we've got the different soft proofs available. So I'm just going to click on the default and you'll immediately have seen some changes to the image. Now what the soft proofing layer is doing is it's causing the image on screen to be represented as if it was a print on your printer. And that includes allowing for things like ink and paper. Now the first thing that I want to do is pick a paper profile. So I've got a lot of profiles installed on my computer, and in the soft proofing window you can see a lot of these different ones. Now the one I want to use is a photo speed paper, so let's pick to start with this natural soft texture paper. Now when I prick that, you can see that the screen changes, so now the screen is representing what the print would look like when printed on that paper. And you'll notice that there's not a lot of black in there, it's much lighter now. And the reason for that is, this is a matte paper, it can't reproduce really dark blacks. Now in this image, there are actually a lot of dark colours. So if we wanted to reproduce this more accurately, what we could do is change our paper to one that could represent a wider range of tones. And that maybe is a smooth pearl paper, or even the platinum baryta paper. Now at this point, I need to explain something called colour gamut. Now when we edit an image, we have a colour space. And if you look at this image, it's actually been edited in Adobe RGB color space, which is quite wide. The papers that we're using here probably can't display all the colors that are possible in the Adobe RGB color space. Now that Adobe RGB color space, it has a range of colors that it can represent. And if a color goes outside of that range, it's referred to as being out of gamut. Because this platinum baryta paper probably has a different colour range to the colour space we've edited in, it means that colours could go outside of what could be reproduced on that paper. And those colours are then referred to as being out of gamut. And you've got a little box down here that allows you to do a gamut check. Let's tick that and see what happens. Now immediately you can see a lot of grey has appeared. And what's happening here is that Affinity is representing as grey pixels the areas that it can't reproduce on the chosen paper. So what will happen is that the printer and the computer will make some adjustments to those areas you see in grey to allow them to be printed. So let's turn that off for the moment. And you can see that the areas that were grey are the very dark areas. And that's because the black that can get reproduced on a print is always lighter than you would have on a computer screen. So it will never look quite the same. Now, what happens if a colour is out of gamut? Well, that depends on something called the rendering intent here. The default is absolute colorimetric, but there are other rendering intents. We've got perceptual relative saturation as well. If you're used to printing in something like Lightroom, you'll probably recognize perceptual and relative. Let's have a look at perceptual. Now you notice there that the image suddenly became lighter. What's happening when we choose the perceptual rendering intent is that Affinity takes all the colors in the Adobe RGB color space for this image and it tries to compress them down into the color gamut or range of colors that the platinum baryta paper here that we've picked can represent. If I choose another paper, you'll see because that's got an even narrower color range, it makes it look even lighter. Now, let's have a look at what happens with relative colorimetric. Now, the image looks slightly darker and slightly more as we may intend it to. And actually, that may be good enough to print. What's happening when we pick relative colorimetric is that the computer is identifying those colors that are out of gamut, and it's assigning them to the closest in gamut color. So what you get is that there's less lightening of the image because this is a dark image. Instead, only the areas that fell out of gamut are being adjusted. If we go to saturation, what the image is trying to do here, what the computer is trying to do here, is preserve the saturation and brightness in the colors. And because of that, it's looking a little bit like the perceptual rendering intent. Now, the rendering intent that tends to preserve the color accuracy best is this absolute colorimetric. And immediately you can see this now looks like the original image to some degree. If I go to my layers panel, I'll turn off the softproof. And you can see there's actually very little difference. So if I print this image as it is now without the softproof, that's how it will look in the print if I use the Platinum Baryta paper. If I check the gamut check though, you can see that some of the tones are out of gamut. And what might happen is that those will look a little bit too dark in our print, and they'll just be pure black. So what we can do is we can add an adjustment to our image to compensate in those areas so that the printer can handle them a little bit better. So let's have a look at how we do that. And the first thing I want to point out is that this softproofing layer should always go on the very top of your layer stack. And that's because if you add adjustments over the top of it, they won't be properly reproduced as a softproof. So let's now pick this layer, my adjustment one just below the softproof, and we can add a curves adjustment to this. Now, before I go any further, I just want to go back to my softproof and I want to see the gamut check. And now, using the curves, I can actually take the black point here, because that's one of the problem areas, and increase it. And you can see that very few areas now are falling out of gamut. I can now, though, because the image is looking a little bit light, drag the curve down. And there we've just affected the areas that we wanted to adjust because of the darkening problem. So let's go back and turn off the gamut check. And you can see now there's more detail in the shadow areas than there was previously. Now, the other thing that often causes problems is saturation. So let's now again click the next layer down below the softproof, and we'll add the HSL adjustment. I'll just use a default. It may be that reducing the saturation gets rid of the gamut problems, and it does to some degree, but I don't want to lose a lot of saturation. So I may still be getting a problem with the luminosity in those areas. So I can just increase very slightly. By lightening the image across the entire tonal range, it seems to have reduced the problems with out of gamut colors. And that may allow me to actually increase some of my saturation. And I'm going to actually pick the reds here and just boost my saturation there. And I can also, if I want to, change the hue of my reds to make them maybe a little bit redder. So I'm quite happy with how that's now looking. So let's just go back to the layers. Let's go back to the softproof and we'll take our gamut check off. And now what I've got is an image that if I print it and it looks like this, I'd actually be quite pleased with it. So I'm going to now turn off the softproof. And there's not too much difference. Now, one of the things that got to remember to do is these three layers really are all together as one, and they're all to do with printing. If I turn off that group of layers, that's my original print, which I can't reproduce because my printer inks don't have a large enough dynamic range. But that's how it would look, and actually that's not too bad at all. Maybe we could increase the contrast just a little bit by using the curves adjustment here. And that doesn't look too bad at all. Now, that's my softproof complete. The thing to remember when you come to actually print this though is remove the soft proof actual adjustment here, because it is an adjustment. It will affect the output, and you don't need it to, because what we've got here with this HSL curves layer and all the other adjustments is something that will reproduce the image in a way that I like on the print. And because this layer, or this group of layers, is only to do with the print, I'm going to turn it off until I come to actually print. When I want to print, I'll turn it on and I'll send this image as it is to the printer. So that is how color gamuts work, rendering intents work, and soft proofing work in Affinity Photo. I hope you found that useful. I'm Robin Whalley. You've been watching Lenscraft. I'll see you next week for another video.